Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes. This is biology session, nutrition animals, part 4. So far we have studied what is the nutrition, the types of nutrition, and especially the nutrition in human beings. In the last class we have completed up to the process of digestion. In today's class we are going to discuss about assimilation and the remaining process, and also we are going to discuss about the digestive system of ruminants are the special group of animals. So example cow, how the digestive system and the process of digestion we are going to discuss. Okay, are you ready children? Let us proceed. Assimilation. What is digestion? Digestion is the process of breaking down of complex food substances into simplest food particles or substances in the presence of enzymes is called as digestion. The digestion is followed by assimilation. So in multicellular organisms or in animals, the nutrition is divided into several steps. We have completed ingestion, then digestion, absorption, also completed. Now assimilation, and the last one is digestion. What is assimilation? Assimilation is the movement of digested food molecules into the cells of the body and their utilization for different vital activities is called assimilation. For example, glucose is used in the process of respiration for the production of energy. Amino acids are used in the synthesis of proteins or to build the new proteins. Okay, this is called assimilation. Assimilation, in simple words, we can define it as the process of utilization of digested food. The process of utilization of digested food materials for different purposes is called assimilation. So after assimilation, the next step in the nutrition, digestion. Digestion, it is also called defecation. The elimination of undigested food material or the feces from the alimentary canal is called digestion or defecation. The feces is the waste matter discharged from the alimentary canal. Okay, it passes out through the last part of the alimentary canal, that is anus. Okay, by means of the sphincter muscles it is eliminated out, defecation or digestion. Okay, see absorption and assimilation, you can see here. So villus singular, villi means plural, in the small intestine, that is ileum of the small intestine, possess finger like projections called villi. So each villus, if you take, it is richly supplied with blood capillaries. It possesses lymphatic vessels called lacteals. Okay, and the blood vessels, arteriole, venules are present. So after digestion, the digested food materials in the form of amino acids, monosaccharides. Monosaccharides means glucose, fructose, simple carbohydrates. Okay, and fatty acids and glycerols. So they are all absorbed into the blood. Okay, so after that absorption, so those the products of digestion, amino acids, some of them are utilized in the production of new proteins. The glucose or the monosaccharides, they are used in the production of energy in the process of respiration. okay. So this is the process of assimilation, and the digestion is the final process. Undigested food material is eliminated from the body. If it is retained in the body, then it may cause some problems. Okay. So digestion means it is the elimination of the indigestible remains of the food from the alimentary canal. It is also called defecation or evacuation. Evacuation. The waste matter discharged from the alimentary canal is called as feces or stool. It is also called stool. So assimilation helps in energy production. It helps in the growth and also repair. Okay, let us discuss a few words about the digestive disorders also. So there is a disorder which is most common, that is jaundice. Jaundice is caused by excess presence of bilirubin, a pigment present in the bile juice, in the blood, and its deposition in skin, mucous membranes, and the sclera of eye. Okay, eye, skin, and the urine turns yellow color in the jaundice due to the deposition of bilirubin pigment. Vomiting. What is vomiting? Vomiting is the forcible expulsion of the contents of stomach through the mouth. Next, diarrhea. Diarrhea is an excessive frequency. It is an excessive frequency and liquidity of fecal matter. Okay, loose motions. Loose watery motions called as diarrhea. Then constipation. It is the most common problem in the aged people. Constipation is infrequent or irregular passage of dry hardened feces. They feel difficulty in the defecation. Next, indigestion. It is also most common problem. It is caused by intolerance to an ingredient of food, defect in stomach. Okay, example, hyperchlorohydria or intestine inadequate enzyme secretion, food poisoning, overeating, and consumption of spiny food materials will lead to indigestion. Indigestion you will face at the time of attending regular functions. It may lead to indigestion. Okay. Next, nutritional requirement of human beings. So we need different nutrients. The first one is energy yielding nutrients. Carbohydrates and lipids are the chief energy giving nutrients, and proteins can also give energy, but in the absence of these carbohydrates, proteins also will release energy. Bodybuilding nutrients. Bodybuilding nutrients are the proteins. They are the chief bodybuilding nutrients made up of amino acids. The metabolic regulators. Metabolic regulators are protective foods. They are vitamins, water, and mineral salts. Vitamins, water, and mineral salts. They are micronutrients and they are also essential nutrients. They are required in small quantities. And hereditary substances, that is nucleic acids, DNA and RNA. The next, besides the carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, and water, roughage. It is also called dietary fiber. It is also very much essential in the diet to avoid the constipation problem. Dietary fiber must be included in the food which we eat. So now let us proceed to next important part of the lesson. Ruminants digestive system. So what is a ruminant? A ruminant is a grass eating animal. It's a herbivore. In grass eating animals like herbivores, like the cow, deer, ox, buffalo and sheep. So these group of animals, they swallow the food without chewing. Without chewing, they swallow the food. Next, after feeding, after swallowing, they bring back the food. You see here, it will swallow directly, the cow. After feeding, they bring back the food from the stomach back into the mouth and chew thoroughly. So this process is called rumination. And such animals are called ruminants. Okay, what is rumination? The animals like herbivorous animals like cow swallow the food without chewing and bring back the food into the mouth and chew leisurely. This process is called rumination. And such group of animals are called ruminants. Though their main diet is plants, they are unable to digest because of lack of cellulose breaking enzyme. Okay. The food which they eat, the main ingredient of their food is a complex carbohydrate that is called cellulose. Cellulose is an important constituent of the all the food materials which are consumed by the herbivores. So in order to digest this cellulose, one enzyme is required that is called cellulase. Cellulase is the enzyme which digests cellulose. So that enzyme is not produced naturally in the digestive system of the ruminants. Okay. So what they do? They seek the help from the some microorganisms which are naturally living along with the animal. They are present in the rumen of these animals. Okay. This is the stomach. The stomach of these ruminants is divided into four chambers. It's very large in size. What are the four chambers? Rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. Okay. Rumen, reticulum, omasum, abomasum. So they are the, these are the four main chambers present in the ruminant stomach, out of which rumen is the largest chamber, in which certain flagellate protozoans and the bacteria present. So there is a symbiotic association. You studied in the nutrition in plants. So there is one nutrition called symbiotic nutrition. Symbiotic nutrition means two different organisms live together. They help each other. So here also the microflagellates, that is these microorganisms which are present in the rumen of the cow, they provide this enzyme, cellulase enzyme, and the animal provide food to the those microorganisms. This kind of association where both are benefited, it is called symbiotic association or symbiosis. So let us see more. For cellulase enzyme, they maintain a symbiotic relationship with microorganisms. Which maintain? So these ruminants maintain a symbiotic relationship with microorganisms. The microbes help in breaking down the cellulose, the constituent which is the main constituent of the plant cell wall. So the ruminant have one stomach with four compartments or chambers for the digestion of food. The first chamber is rumen. Rumen is the first chamber, the largest organ that allows for bacterial and chemical breakdown of that cellulosic fibers. Okay, so what are the four chambers? That is rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. Rumen, first chamber, reticulum, second chamber, then omasum and abomasum. The abomasum is the chamber which represent our stomach. Okay, duodenum. So this is the ruminant's digestive system. The first chamber is the rumen, which contain large number of microorganisms, that is the bacteria and flagellate protozoans. Okay, so here in the second chamber, reticulum, the second chamber called as a honeycomb because of the honeycomb appearance of its lining. Reticulum, rumen is followed by reticulum. Then what is the function of this reticulum? It collects the smaller particles and moves them into the omasum, while the larger particles remain in the rumen for further digestion. Okay, the smaller, so first what the animal will feed without chewing. Again it sit leisurely and bring back the food into the mouth and chew thoroughly. Then it is swallows. That food enters into the smaller particles, enters into the reticulum, second chamber, and the larger particles again enters into the rumen. So reticulum also traps the foreign material that the animal may picks up. It stores the foreign objects and prevents the damaging items enter into the digestive tract. So that's why, you know very well, nowadays in the towns and cities, these herbivorous animals, these domestic animals like cows and buffaloes, they are eating the covers, polythene covers and hair. These are unwanted substances which they consume. So those unwanted particles will be not allowed into the next part of the stomach. They are struck, they are stopped in the reticulum itself. Okay, it is the mechanism present in these ruminants. So here once again, rumen is the largest chamber, second chamber is the reticulum, omasum. So after the food second time, the food first enters into the rumen. So it mixes with the bacteria and other flagellate protozoans. It enters into the mouth, chew thoroughly, and that food enters into the reticulum. In the reticulum, the smaller particles of the food will be placed, and the larger particles again passed into the rumen, and the unwanted any materials are there, they are stored in the reticulum itself, they are stopped in the reticulum itself. Okay, next, omasum. Omasum is the third chamber. It helps in the absorption of water, magnesium and some volatile fatty acids produced by the rumen fermentation. They have not been observed into the bloodstream yet. So here the products of digestion are also different in the ruminants. So actually the carbohydrates are converted into glucose finally. But whereas in ruminants, the glucose is further fermented because anaerobic conditions are present, the bacteria are present, flagellate protozoans are present. So the fermented glucose forms the butyric acid and propionic acid. Butyric acid and propionic acid, they are the fatty acids, volatile fatty acids. So these fatty acids provide more energy to the animal. That's why structurally or body wise, if you see also, these ruminants are very stout. Though they are eating grass, grass eating animals, herbivores, but they are the products of digestion are different. So cellulose is the complex carbohydrate. After the digestion, in the presence of cellulase enzyme, then the glucose is fermented to volatile fatty acids. So that's why more energy is produced. So they are very strong. Okay, rumen fermentation, it is called rumen fermentation. So that they have not been absorbed into the bloodstream yet in the omasum. Then it enters into the abomasum, the fourth chamber. This is called the true stomach, which represent the higher vertebrate stomach. Most similar to the stomach in a non-ruminant. Okay. So majority of the chemicals breakdown of the food materials occur in the abomasum, last chamber, with the help of digestive enzymes, just like us, pepsin, renin. Okay, these are the enzymes, and even bile juice also present, and the hydrochloric acid present in the stomach, which kills the bacteria which enters along with the digested food materials. So that bacteria are acted upon by these protease enzymes, and the enzyme present in that flagellate protozoans and the bacteria are utilized by this animal. Okay. So as they are very microorganisms, they can reproduce very fast in the stomach. So there is no harm. But some of the bacteria and the flagellate protozoans which enter into the abomasum are killed by the hydrochloric acid and are digested by the proteases enzymes and utilized by the animal. Okay. The abomasum secretes mucus to protect its wall from the acid damage. Just like our digestive tract is protected by the mucus, here also the digestive tract of the ruminants is also protected by mucus membrane to prevent the damage from the acid. Okay, children. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.